all of fiction, there have been many iconic rivalries. Mario versus Sonic, Goku versus Superman, and who could forget Sans Undertale versus Bill Cipher Gravity Falls.
But the one we will be focusing on today is one that has existed as long as they've both starred in movies. The legendary kaiju rivalry between Godzilla, King of the Monsters, and King Kong.
Both of these iconic behemoths have the title of king, but today, one of them gets dethroned. Today, we rewind Rumble. Before these titans clash, we must first go over what they're capable of. But before we do that, we must cover their origins.
The tale of Godzilla is one that any monster movie fan would already know by now. Atomic bombs being dropped in the ocean awakened the giant radioactive lizard as old as civilization, acting as a warning for the nuclear apocalypse.
After his awakening, Godzilla would go on to terrorize Japan, destroying any city unlucky enough to be caught in his path. But when push came to shove and the planet was threatened by other giant monsters, Godzilla would act as Earth's first line of defense, protecting the planet from those who would try to bring it harm.
As for Kong, he's a giant ape who resides on Skull Island, an island filled to the brim with many different monsters.
Kong may be the only one of his kind left, but quality over quantity.
That's a terrible mindset to have when your species is on the brink of extinction.
Well, regardless, Kong is a great note for a species to go out on. His strength is ridiculous. He's the king of his island for a reason.
And on top of his amazing levels of strength, he's also quite a smart fighter, being able to use his surroundings to his advantage during a fight, like when he used a boat's propeller and a tree as weapons against the giant skull crawler.
We've been talking up Kong's strength, but how strong is he actually? I heard he punched the moon out of orbit once.
Wrong Kong there, buddy.
Wrong Kong? I thought his name was King Kong.
We'll come back to Kong's strength in a minute. Let's go back and talk about Godzilla real quick, since he has many more powers to go over.
On top of Godzilla's ridiculous strength, as would be standard for someone his size, he also has his signature atomic breath, a beam of radiation which the big lizard fires from his mouth. And if his standard blue breath beam isn't quite enough, he could amp it up to the red spiral ray, far increasing the power of the attack.
Godzilla also emits a deadly amount of radiation anywhere he goes, and if he wants to amp that to 11 and nuke his surroundings, he can use the nuclear pulse, an omnidirectional blast of radiation that destroys anyone unlucky enough to be hit by it.
And if you can somehow get past his radiation attacks, good luck actually doing any damage to him, since his healing factor can quickly patch up any injuries he sustains during battle.
Kong is a powerhouse, being able to easily take on the most dangerous creatures on Skull Island, like T-Rexes, Skullcrawlers, and even Godzilla himself. These guys already fought before, and Kong could generate lightning in that movie? What the actual hell?
Save it for the post-analysis. Kong also has some good durability feats, surviving military-grade gunfire and an entire lake of napalm blowing up in his face.
Godzilla has fought his fair share of monsters as well, from mechanical and alien versions of himself to King Ghidorah, the alpha of the Monsterverse himself.
There's also the time he vored the aforementioned King Ghidorah.
What?
Yeah, he ate him as his atomic breath vaporized him. Vored him. For lack of a better word.
It would have costed you $0.00 to not say that. Why are you like this?
Well, moving on. Neither character is perfect. Both have died before several times, both more times than the MCU has had bad movies, as well as more times than the DCEU had good ones.
Godzilla, in particular, is weak to weapons like the Oxygen Destroyer, and man-made electricity can harm him very easily.
These two titans technically will officially throw down again on the big screen in 2020, but until then, let's see if we can figure out who will win beforehand. It's time to Rewind Rumble.
And now, let's get ready for the fight. This battle will take place on Earth, and remember, there is no prep time. Let the battle begin!
Hopefully you enjoyed that animation, and if you did, super special thanks to Team Animation Rewind's Juan. I'd also like to thank Biff Weed for putting together this script, with the help of Corin O'Keefe for the research/notes, and super special thanks to One Fish Mob for co-hosting this episode. Thanks to all, and enjoy the post-analysis. And Godzilla wins. This shouldn't be too surprising to many people if you know what these two can do. We even purposely didn't include much in the pre-analysis to try and make this seem closer. There was so many things we left out there that would show just how badly Kong gets stomped, including the fact that we were compositing both characters.
Since we left out the vast majority of important feats and stats in the pre-analysis, we'll try and go over everything worth bringing up here.
Let's start off with exclusive feats from the MonsterVerse, the cinematic universe, which will have these two fight next year. Kong is easily able to keep up with building-sized skull crawlers, can easily throw around giant trees, destroy military-grade choppers, and survived a lake of napalm exploding beneath him. Though that did knock him out.
Compare that to Godzilla, who took down several Mudos in his 2014 movie, and just one Mudo was able to absorb the energy from an entire nuclear power plant. There's also Godzilla being able to at least somewhat scale the King Ghidorah, who was able to create a Category 5 hurricane just by flying. Already, with just the MonsterVerse, Godzilla has far more impressive feats than Kong, as well as being 3 times larger than the Big Monkey Man. It only gets worse for Kong when we start factoring in other sources.
The only other noteworthy feats Kong has come from the 2005 movie featuring famous YouTuber Jablinski Games. But even then, they're still in the same ballpark as some of his MonsterVerse feats. He can take on massive dinosaurs, shake trees, break stone, and survive being hit with a massive rock while off guard.
Godzilla has many more feats coming from his much wider array of movies, where he has feats like tanking a city busting meteor without flinching, and other monsters he can scale to could destroy meteors that threaten to destroy the planet. He even survived the black hole. He's already so far out of Kong's league that it's depressing. But would you believe me if I said there was even more to cover?
Godzilla's greatest showings come from his appearances in the comics, mainly his crossovers with Marvel and the Godzilla in Hell storyline.
Not only has the big lizard boy conquered Hell and returned home from the dead in the Godzilla in Hell storyline, but when he crossed over with the Marvel Universe, he was able to match Thor in a fight and cause Hercules to struggle when lifting up one of his feet when he tried to stomp on him. For reference, this is the same Hercules who could easily hold up the weight of the entire universe.
All of this paints a pretty good picture about how Godzilla is way out of Kong's league. Kong shouldn't be able to even scratch him, but even if he could, Godzilla's regeneration has allowed him to come back just from his heart alone.
But all of this is under the impression that Kong could even touch Godzilla, but the gap in speed basically guarantees that he wouldn't be able to even get close to him. Kong doesn't have much putting him above the subsonic ranges. He can move really fast for someone of his size and react to helicopters, but that's about it. Godzilla could easily react to Megaguirus, who can move at speeds of Mach 4, and that's one of Godzilla's lowest showings.
When Godzilla crossed over with Marvel, he fought Thor. Thor and many other characters on his level, like Silver Surfer, have many feats where they cross intergalactic distances in moments, easily putting them in the ranges of billions to trillions of times the speed of light. I'm not saying Godzilla can directly scale to these characters, but just being on par with them makes Kong look like a statue in comparison. Imagine a fighter jet trying to outrace the Big Bang. That's essentially the speed gap we're dealing with here.
Kong does have his lightning attacks from the King Kong vs. Godzilla movie, which would give him massively hypersonic attack speeds, but even then it still wouldn't be anything in comparison to Godzilla.
Wait, we forgot to mention the results of that movie. Kong won that fight, so wouldn't he scale to Godzilla, and wouldn't his lightning powers take advantage of Godzilla's weakness and allow him to win?
It would let Kong scale to that specific version of Godzilla, but not Godzilla from the Godzilla vs. Megaguirus universe, the Monsterverse, Godzilla in Hell, and especially not from Marvel. Those are all entirely separate versions of Godzilla which Kong has never fought and therefore can't scale to. And as for the lightning powers, it's unclear how they would work on Godzilla. We do know that Kong has natural lightning generation, so it's unclear whether that would count as natural or man-made electricity. If it's man-made, he still isn't strong enough to kill Godzilla with it, and if it's natural, Godzilla can harness it and grow more powerful. Kong loses either way.
Well, Kong may be strong, but Godzilla proved to us all that he's the real king of the monsters, making the winner of this rumble, Godzilla. On the next episode of Rewind Rumble!